The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita.
Vandeham Sri Guru.
The following is a lecture given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 2nd of February, 1968, in Los Angeles, California.
वैराग्य विद्या निज भक्ति योगम शिक्षार्थमेक पुरुष पुराण श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य शरीर धारी कृपां बुधिज्जस्तमहं प्रपद्ये. दिस वर्स वाज कंपोज बाय सार्वभौम भट्टाचार्य. यू नो सार्वभौम भट्टाचार्य? यू हैव नॉट हर्ड?
यस.
हु इज ही? Who was Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya? Yeah. And Nandarani knows better than you. So girls are intelligent. Yes. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was a great impersonalist and a great logician. The impersonalist school, amongst them, there are very, very learned scholars. Shankaracharya himself, he was a unique scholar. At the age of 8 years only, he studied all the Vedas. And not only he studied, he became a critical student, Shankaracharya. He was incarnation of Lord Shiva. Therefore, nobody can be compared with him. So amongst the impersonalist school, there are many great logicians and high-class scholars, but according to Vedic principles, God realization does not depend on material intelligence or scholarship. It is stated in the Vedas, Nayam Atma Prabhasanena Labhya. You cannot realize the self simply by arguments or very scholarly speeches. No. Nayam Atma Prabhasanena Labhya Na Bahuna Sutena. Neither by studying many, many different types of Vedic literatures. Nāyam ātmā pravacane na labhya, na bhuna suti na, na medhaya. Neither by sharp brain or memory. These are good qualifications to be scholarly, to be a very good speaker, and to have very good memorizing power. These are materially very good qualifications, but they are not qualification for realizing God. Then what is the qualification of realizing God? Jamevaisa brinite tena labhya. God can be realized only to whom He reveals. You cannot oblige God to become manifest before you because you are a very good scholar or you are a very rich man or you are very good looking or you have got very good memorizing power. No. Jamai Vaisabhinite. When he is pleased, then he reveals unto the devotee. Therefore, our business should be for God realization, to please Him. And that pleasing process is this devotional service. Let us engage in His service, and when He becomes pleased, yes, He's very sincerely. Just like the gopis, they were village girls, not even born of very high family, cowherds. an ordinary agriculturist, cowherdsman. So, the how much education you got? There was no education practically. In the village, even men in India still, they are 90% illiterate. And what to speak of the girls? The men are not even literate. Because according to Vedic civilization, it was not necessary that everyone should go to school. There was no necessity. Because the things were being learned by Shruti, by oral reception, knowledge from the perfect man, one would hear and he would become learned. There was no necessity of learning ABCD, no. Even in Vedic age, everything was memorized. There was nothing in writing. People were so sharp in brain that once heard from the spiritual master, they will never forget. The Brahmachari system made their brain so powerful that whatever they will hear from the spiritual master, they will keep in the brain and never forget. They will repeat verbatim. Smriti. This is called retaining power. So, God realization does not depend on material opulence. Material opulence means to take birth in high family, janma. Janma means high parentage. Then janma is hajjan and wealthy, great riches. These are material opulence. High parentage, great riches, and great learning, and great beauty. These four things are material opulences. Janma isharja sutastri. Janma means birth, isharja means wealth, and sruta means education, and sri means beauty. For God realization, these things are not essential. But Krishna consciousness movement can utilize everything, so nothing is neglected. That is another point. But if somebody thinks that I have got all these opulences, therefore God realization is very easy for me. No, that is not. So God realization depends on God, because God, you cannot oblige God by some force. Just like if you have got money, you can do anything nowadays. If you have got strength of wealth, you can have any power, you can do anything. But that does not mean that you can purchase God. No, that is not possible. If you have got beauty, you can conquer over very stalwart, very strong man, just like Cleopatra. You have heard the Grecian history. She was very beautiful and she conquered many great warriors. So beauty sometimes can conquer even the greatest man. But that does not mean beauty can conquer God. No, that is not possible. The Vairagya Vidya, Nija Bhakti, to conquer God is bhakti. If you are advanced in devotional service, then you can conquer God. Just like the gopis, as I was speaking, their parentage was not very high, not at all high. Village agriculturists, farmers, no education, practical, no education at all. And they are not rich at all. Agriculturists, farmers, they are not very rich. So, how they conquered Krishna? Krishna was just a play toy in their hands. Gopi bhavarasam dagdhar. They conquered Krishna simply by devotional service. That's it. They did not know anything except Krishna. They did not care anything. Always they are thinking of Krishna. The one instance of their absorption in Krishna consciousness is explained that when Krishna was going on the pasturing ground, the gopis were crying at home. Why? They were thinking that Krishna, his body is so delicate, so soft, that when we take his lotus feet and place on our breast or chest, we think it is hard, very hard for him. So Krishna is walking in the forest. There are so many particles of stones. They are freaking. And how much Krishna is feeling pain. This thinking may cause their crying. How Krishna is feeling pain. And the whole day they will think of Krishna like that. And when Krishna will come back from the pasturing ground, then they will be relieved. But Krishna has now come back. This was their business. Now this sort of thinking of Krishna does not require any riches or any high parentage or any beauty or any education. So we have to develop such Krishna consciousness. Our this Gaudiya Sampradaya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's descendants, our line of God realization is that separation, feeling of separation. Not that we have got Krishna within our hand, no. This feeling of separation, worship of Krishna by feeling of separation, is better than the worship by directly meeting. Vipralamba seva. So, this Vairagya Vidya renunciation, Vairagya Vidya nija Bhakti Yoga. Bhakti Yoga means Vairagya Vidya. Vairagya Vidya means no more attachment for this material. That is Vairagya. So, Bhakti Yoga means Vairagya Vidya. This Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya says Vairagya Vidya nija Bhakti Yoga. This Vairagya Vidya means Bhakti Yoga. Sikkhartameka Purusa Purana. So Krishna, the Supreme Original Personality, He has come down to teach us this Vairagya Vidya. Vairagya Vidya Nija Bhakti Yogam Sikkhartameka Purusa Purana. Sri Krishna has appeared in the form of Lord Sri Krishna Chaitanya. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya says, my respectful obeisances unto him. So, naturally, this context came into my mind, this voice, Vairagya. So one who becomes advanced in Krishna consciousness, naturally they become disinterested for any material purposes. They do not care. So Vairagya, this Bhakti Yoga means Vairagya Vidya. You can chant waves. Oh, where from you got it? Oh. What is the price of this?
No charge.
No, what do they say?
Oh, this drum was broken, but he gave it to us free. I do not know what.
It is broken?
It was broken, but we fixed it.
When they give in charity, they give something broken. Kana Guru Bhavan ke Dana. In India, there is a charity is given to the Brahmins. So a man saw that his cow is blind. All right, give it in charity. So, charity means, charity should be the first class thing, if it is really charity. But nowadays people give in charity just for name. Oh, I am giving some. This charity, you have read Bhagavad Gita, there are three kinds of charity. Sattvic, Rajasic, Tamasic. Sattvic, charity in goodness is with due consideration. that here should be given the charity, just like the bathing injunction is to give charity to the Brahmins. Why? That is the worthy place to give charity in the hands of Brahmins and Vaishnava. Real Brahmin, I don't say caste Brahmin, because they will employ whatever you give them in the service of the Lord. There is no question of profit or name, but charity should be given here. Here is something, God's service, that is it. And Rajasik means for the sake of name. Oh, people will say, I am so charitable. That is Rajasik. And Tamasik, one who does not know where the money is going, just like in the Bowery streets, drunkard comes and polishes the motor car and somebody gives $5 and immediately goes to drink. That means this charity means give him impetus for drinking. If charity creates such drunkard, that is very dangerous. He has to suffer, the man who is giving in charity. Therefore in charity also there must be consideration. It must be sattvic. Anyway, it has come here, so it is sattvic. Whatever his mind may be, anyway he has given to this temple, so it is sattvic. Chant.